Hello, everyone, and welcome. I am so glad that you are tuning in live, catching the replay, or listening to this episode over on the podcast, because it's a really special episode today. I have another amazing guest, and I just love to really talk about my students because they are doing the most amazing things out there in the world. And today's guest is no different. Before I introduce her, I want to make sure that if this is your first time listening or tuning into us, my name is Yang Pratt. I am a 17-year performing arts studio owner turned chief dreamer and podcaster right here at Our Young Creators. And here at OYC, we love helping people harness the power of technology to show up bigger in the world and make a bigger impact. And one of our favorite ways to do that is through podcasting. So our guest today is Kristi Bridges, and Kristi just graduated from our podcast in a weekend class, and I couldn't be more proud. Kristi, I am so glad you said yes to podcasting and yes to chatting about this journey of yours live today.
I am so glad that you taught that course. When I thought of podcasting, it sounded like something I really wanted, but I couldn't fit it anywhere else into my schedule. And you showed us easy, easy ways to multi-purpose our videos and other things. You made every step just seamless, and I really appreciate that. I teach myself, and so you can tell when someone really knows how to teach and when someone just has information to share, and you really do know how to teach. I appreciate that.
Oh, well, thank you. I've been doing it now for more than 20 years, so it definitely is nice to kind of come full circle. When I started teaching, I started with adults, and then went to kids, and now I'm back to adults again. So it's been a really fun journey to be able to teach all these different ages. And now that I get to share this love that I have of really becoming smart with our marketing so that we're not having to spend hours and hours and hours doing something like a podcast when we can use something like a live video to share with people on a podcast. So if they're on the go, they can still tune in.
Yes. Well, for me, marketing is just not my favorite thing. I want to create, but I don't want to create ad after ad. And podcasting makes marketing so much easier because it's fun. It's a way that I can give value to my listeners and actually just have a conversation with somebody interesting and not feel like I'm just saying, buy this, buy this, buy this.
I agree. I love that fact about podcasting and live video because it is so conversational. People can tune in, they can watch when it's convenient for them, and then we're able to make a bigger impact and serve the world. Can you share with everybody what your background is and how you got to this place of wanting to become a podcaster?
Well, sure. You know, it's funny. I was thinking the other day about how different our youthful ideas of how we're going to use our gifts are. I was in the first grade play, and I was going to graduate high school someday and be a movie star. That was just my goal all the way through school until I fell in love and got married and didn't run off to California. But, you know, there was the gift and the passion for speaking to people and being in front of people and being okay with being in front of people that I've been using ever since. I led a few bands, and then I started thinking, I want to say more than what I'm able to say in a song. Although the songwriting is still a passion of mine, there's so much wisdom that I want to share with people. Not necessarily that I'm ever so wise, but I've been observing all my life where people go wrong and where they go right and how we can make better decisions for ourselves and how we can incorporate certain things into our habits and into our communication styles so that we can live more wisely and have a happier, more fulfilling life. So after the music, I started a business called One Moment Wiser, where I can write and speak and help people find those little tweaks in their life, you know, make those little adjustments that make for a happy life. And podcasting was just a natural outflow of that.
I love that. So the title of your podcast is One Moment Wiser.
Yes.
And I love that you're helping people make those small changes, because sometimes those small changes are the hardest to do that have the biggest impact. So I first want to say congratulations to you for taking your message beyond your local area and now being able to share your gifts with the world. That is a huge accomplishment.
It feels good. Thank you.
My pleasure. Can you tell us who you created this podcast for?
Sure. So I do a daily video that is a scripture verse and a discussion. And that's for those people that want just a little bite-sized devotional so that they can feel close to God, but also make good decisions for their lives. Well, I started the podcast for kind of a wider audience to have an interview, a short interview, about 15 minutes long, with someone who is living wisdom in some unique way. For example, when I interviewed Connie Myers, she created the Kick Butt Leadership course, and she's living wisdom with a mindfulness and a peace that we could all use a little of. And so she shared a tip for how to actually increase your brain power and your peace at the same time. And when I interviewed Angela Stillwell, she actually showed us some body posture moves that increase our self-confidence and reduce our stress hormones. And then when I interviewed you, you talked about how you could help your children. You could actually bond with your children over using technology. Boy, I tell you, raising children, we always need help with that. And so each of you have different aspects of wisdom to share, but it's applicable to all areas of life. And I've enjoyed it very much.
And I love that too. And I want to point that out to everyone who is watching or listening, that everybody, every person was put on this planet with special gifts, special talents. We've lived through different lessons in life. And now I feel like, you know, each person has this moral responsibility to open up and share that. So I think that's a really important takeaway, that no matter what your background is, the lessons you have learned, the different careers you may have had, all of those little pieces together make you who you are. And that needs to be shared with the world, because there is somebody out there waiting to hear from you, because you've lived these things you're going through now. And to know that there is someone on the other side of the earbuds who gets us and who understands, that is the power of podcasting.
It really is. And, you know, for years, I thought someday I want to write a book. But it was always someday, because I didn't feel like I had anything different to say than what had already been said. And then I started to realize we respond to a voice we can identify with. We respond to someone whose story sounds a little bit like ours, or, you know, maybe they went through a different story, but something about them connects with us. So it doesn't matter if someone else has told the same truth that you have to tell. People will identify with you, and you will have an impact on their life in a way that nobody else could.
That is so, so important, and a huge takeaway. If you take nothing else away from this interview, know that,
yes,
that even though your story may be similar to somebody else's, maybe you've done the same coursework or you've been in the same occupation, it doesn't matter, because you're bringing what is uniquely you to the world. And again, a podcast has the capacity to reach people not only in the US or in Canada, but really worldwide. And that is really, really something so special about this movie.
I agree. You know, I will say, I was just preparing for a retreat that I'm going to speak at this weekend. I guess I get to see you there. Woo! And I was thinking about the fact that, you know, when we share what we've been gifted to share, it's not, we can't just go off on opinions, right? We have a lot of opinions. But when you share about podcasting, you share specific usable things that people can do. That class was full of useful things that I could instantly apply. When I share about wisdom, I'm able to share about communication skills, like literal things that we can say or things we can understand about ourselves or about others, things that we can, ways that we can double check ourselves. So it's not just opinion, but we've verified that this is actually functional or that this actually works. And so when you create something, you probably start out with a passion for it, but then you're able to do the research and to learn a little more about it. And pretty soon people go, oh my goodness, this is the expert I want to listen to. This is the person who has the stuff that I need.
And I really just appreciate that too, because you mentioned communication. And I think oftentimes communication is something that people don't think about because, you know, we start talking from the time we're little. So of course we can communicate. Right. But when we start listening to people's voice inflections, we start taking into account their body language and those little tips that you're giving them on your podcast and your guests are bringing, those actionable takeaway tips are so huge because the world is full of lots of very long and verbose people who have amazing things to share, but you know, who has 2 hours to listen to that? You know, sometimes we can make the time, but I just love that, you know, you're doing these bite-sized things, 15, 20 minutes and these smaller conversations. So people really can listen, they can internalize it, and then they can immediately take action because it is the action taking that is going to get us to whatever our next step is.
Agreed.
And can you tell us when you are releasing your podcasts?
Sure. So we're sort of at the beginning. It hasn't been, it's been a lot and then a wait, but there are podcasts available for listening now. And then on the 29th, I am interviewing, it's a Saturday morning at 9 a.m. I'm interviewing a woman, Sandy McCullough, who actually has an etiquette school, but she also teaches financial acumen and just general things that we need to learn that will help us be more successful in job interviews, in careers, and in our own businesses. So she is fascinating. And she'll be on the 29th, Saturday morning. My podcasts generally are every other Saturday at 9 a.m., about 15 to 20 minutes long.
That is awesome. And I love that Sandy is sort of the perfect person to come on your podcast because like many of us, she has many passions and she teaches on many things, which sometimes I think we feel like we are stuck in this box. We are known for one thing and that's all we do. But we both know that there's so many things that make us who we are and different passions we can share. And I think the more that we can share about all those different parts of us, the better that people on the receiving end get to know us and understand, like you mentioned before, that we're like them or they're like us. So we have something we can connect over. And I think, especially in this online world, that is a really key component to building a business of any kind.
I agree. And she actually, you know, it's funny because no matter how many facets of something people teach, there's usually some common thread. And her common thread just really seems to be a kind of a grace and a dignity and a self containment that is just gorgeous to see. I really like it. I have to correct myself. I said the podcasts are every other Saturday morning at 9. The Facebook Live videos are every other Saturday morning at 9. The podcasts are posted right after those are over. Okay. So it might be 9:30 when you'd be able to listen to that.
Fantastic. And I'll make sure after the interview, if you want to come back and, you know, share where people can listen to the podcast live or listen to it on a replay, I would definitely appreciate that. I know Tara, who is tuning in right now, had to run, but I wanted to make sure, Tara, that you know that the podcast Kristi has created, it's called One Moment Wiser. And Tara, I think that this podcast will be so, so good for you on your journey of homeschooling and raising your four babies.
Yay. Oh, homeschoolers are wonderful. If I had raised children, I would have wanted to do that. Totally. My sister's doing a bang up job of it right now.
That's amazing. Yeah, I have such respect for homeschooling parents. We did it for a short time. Now my kids are back in school and they're quite happy there. So I don't think we'll make any adjustments there. But I definitely know that the power of homeschooling is just so incredible on kids these days and the opportunities that they have versus yes. being traditionally schooled.
How
Kristi,
cool.
If there is someone out there who is thinking to themselves, you know, I have something to share. I have a special talent. I have a special way that I do something. And they're thinking maybe a podcast is something that they could do too. What would you recommend to them?
Sure. I definitely would recommend trying the podcast. We are in an era that we've never had this kind of ability to try things out and see what happens like we do now. And so definitely try the podcast. Plan a little bit so that you sound as professional as possible, but don't fault yourself if you're a little goofy that first time or two. That just is normal. Be authentic. And, you know, it really helps if you can choose good people to join you in the podcast so that it's not all the pressure on you.
Absolutely. Those are really great pieces of advice. And I think, you know, becoming a podcaster now because of technology has become a little bit easier. And especially when you come together with other people who want to do the same and they're leading with their heart for service and serving others. I mean, that's really the bottom line. And everyone who's gone through our course, that everyone has such a huge heart. They're giving so much of themselves on their live videos and to their clients and in their everyday dealings. And I just think it's the perfect place then to be able to serve more and serve bigger and really just, I always use this word, but to make a bigger impact, because if more people have access to your One Moment Wiser and they can get some information they can take action on immediately, I mean, the ripple effect of that is just astronomical. And I just get so excited talking about this medium. So if you're listening and you want to create a podcast, or maybe you want to bring your kids into this journey, I do that personally. My kids help me in everything that we do. And it's such a great experience to not only bond, but really to teach them skills they can take with them after they leave the house.
That is a future building bunch of skills. It's not just the tech. It's the self-presentation. It's the creative planning. So many things. And the reliability. There's so many things that build the kind of character that will help build their careers. I love it. And Tae Young's podcasting class, the podcast in a weekend, was so fun with the group involvement and just the really easy, bite-sized, actionable pieces. Oh, I'm so glad you did it.
Well, thank you. And I'm so glad you said yes to that. And before we wrap up and you have to run to your next class, mm-hmm. can you let everyone know where they can connect with you online?
Oh, certainly. So in most, well, pretty much any podcast service that you use, it's going to be the number one, the actual numeral one, Moment Wiser. And on Facebook and Twitter, it's also One Moment Wiser and YouTube. And then the website is onemomentwiser.com.
Fantastic. And for those of you listening, definitely reach out, listen to the podcast. And here's what I would ask of you if you are listening. I would love to help Kristi get to a really great place inside of iTunes. And the way she can get to this really special spot called New and Noteworthy is that the more people who subscribe to the podcast and who leave her a review and a rating, that's going to elevate her up inside of iTunes and let her podcast be seen by more people. So I hope you'll join me in doing all those steps, subscribing, rating, and reviewing the podcast, because it is one that people need to hear. these little moments of wisdom. We all need to be reminded from time to time, and Kristi's podcast and her guests are definitely going to help us remember things about ourselves to improve our lives in these little bite-sized segments.
Thank you so much. Yes.
Well, I want to thank everybody for tuning in today. My name is Yang Pratt from Our Young Creators, and we've had a wonderful conversation with Kristi Bridges, a brand new podcaster whose podcast, One Moment Wiser, is now available on iTunes and many of your favorite listening platforms. I wish you all a wonderful day, and we'll catch you next time. Cheers, everybody.